This tutorial is brought to you by PhotoshopTalent.com. Today's tutorial is going to be a little bit different than usual, more of an advanced tutorial, and I had a few requests asking, how do I create a cartoon character, but not my original idea, not my own creativity, but an existing cartoon character. So I started looking around the internet and started looking at cartoon shows, and I wanted to find a cartoon, a character that had distinct features that can be easily reproduced in Photoshop. And I finally came to the idea I should do a tutorial on how to create Stewie Griffin from Family Guy. Now Stewie, as you all know, has a very distinct head. It's kind of like a football shaped, and there's really nothing too advanced to his design. So we're going to be creating Stewie. We're going to do it in two steps. The first tutorial is going to be focused on his head only, and the next tutorial will be his body. Now you have to remember, if you do follow along and you do create Stewie, you cannot use it for commercial purposes. You can use it for your own entertainment, but you cannot use it for commercial purposes. I don't even know if I'm allowed to be doing this. So if the tutorial disappears, you know why. So the first thing you should do is get reference photos. So the best place to do it is Google. Go to Google, go to images, type in Stewie Griffin, and you've got your reference photos. Now we're going to be doing Stewie primarily from the front. Now I haven't been able to find many photos of Stewie from a perfect frontal view, but we can compromise there. So we have pictures like this one, the first one here, where we can see pretty much all of his features in a nice high quality image. Now we're not going to be tracing this because that would be too easy. We're going to be using what we've learned in previous tutorials to actually recreate Stewie. So we're going to go into Photoshop here. We're going to leave this in the background so we can see it. We're going to start off by creating a new document. We're going to make it, let's say, 500 by 300. And here we go. So we're going to start off by creating the main shape of his head. So we know that his head is sort of football shaped, which would be an eclipse. So we're going to go over to the side and we're going to grab our ellipse tool. And we're going to draw out a basic ellipse like so. And if you want, you can change the color to approximately the color of his head, if that makes it any easier. Now remember, you can change the color later on, so it's not too important. It's a little bit more pink. I'm going to leave it at that for now. We will change it later on. So here we go. We have the shape of his head, but it's a little bit off. As you can see on the actual Stewie, it kind of goes inwards, a little bit sharper at the edges where the ears come in. So what we're going to do, we're going to go over to the side and we're going to grab our direct selection tool. The shortcut is A. Now we're going to click and we see the outline of our shape. Now once we have the outline, we can actually start editing the nodes that make up this shape. So we're going to click and drag, and we're going to see the node. We're going to see this left node here, and when we click on that node, we will see two other nodes that appear. What we're going to do, we're going to hold shift and drag the top one down, and then drag the bottom one up. This kind of pinches the corners, giving it a little bit more of a football shape. Now we're going to click on the right node and do the exact same thing, like so. And if you want to get really accurate, you can use rulers, which we're going to do in 1 second. So now that we have our basic shape of the head, we're going to add the ears. So basically, the ears are somewhat of an ellipse as well. So we're going to grab, make sure our head is selected. We're going to grab our ellipse tool, go up to the top and click on this button right here, which is add to shape area. Basically, that'll add your new shape directly onto your original shape. And once that's done, we're going to drag out an ear like so. And now we have an ear onto his head. Now you can edit this by going to the path selection tool, not the direct selection tool, but the path selection tool. What that'll do, that'll allow you to move each individual shape that you've added to your object, like so. So we're going to pop this right about here, maybe move it a little bit out. And then to duplicate it, all you have to do is hold down Alt and Shift and drag it. Now we're going to drag it all the way, keep holding Shift so it keeps on the same line. And we're going to pop it right there. So now if we zoom back out, we have the basic shape of his head with the ears. Now if we wanted to, which we're going to do, we're going to go up to, with our shape selected, we're going to go up to Layer, Layer Style, Stroke. This is going to add a cartoon style outline to his head. We're going to make the stroke black, and we're going to make it a value of 2. And click OK. So now, as you can see, I have to turn off MSN. So now, as you can see, we have the shape of his head with the ears. Hold on one second. There we go. Okay. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to design his eyes. Now, his eyes are primarily in the center of his head and a little bit pushed outwards towards the side. So how do we assure that they are actually positioned in the center of the head? Well, we're going to use our rulers. As you can see at the top, we have rulers at the top and down the side. If you do not see that, if you're on a Mac, hold Command and press R. If you're on a PC, hold Control and press R. Once that's done, we're going to drag out our rulers until it snaps in the center. As you can see, it does snap, and we're going to drag another one like so. So now we have our rulers that are snapped in the center of the image. This right here is the direct center of his head. So now we're going to create eye number one. We're going to focus on one eye, and then we're going to duplicate that as the other eye. So we're going to start off by selecting our ellipse tool. We're going to make it white. And we're going to make sure that it's not at this one here, because we were at that. We want to create a whole new shape. So we're going to create new shape layer. Okay. And we're going to draw out, holding down your shift key to restrain it as a circle, we're going to draw out an eye. We can always change the shape later, but we're going to draw it out around there. Now with that done, we're going to snap it to the center by moving it. You'll see it snaps. And then we're just going to move it over. I'm going to move it down a little bit. There we go. One trick to do to make sure, snap it and then count how many times you move it over. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then down 1. This will help later on when you're positioning the second eye as well. Now, how do we create the eyelids of Stewie? Right now, we're not going to create them on a slant like they are in this picture. We're going to create them fairly straight. This is what we're going to do. We're going to go to our rectangle tool, and we are going to select the skin color again, making sure it's a new layer again, and we're going to draw out sort of an eyelid on top of his eye. Now, it looks strange because it's not actually in the eye, but we're going to fix that right now. I'm going to hide my rulers. And what we're going to do, we're going to go over to our layers palette. And this here is the eyelid. I can name this just to make it easy. Eyelid. And this here is the left eye. What we're going to do with this selected, we're going to hold down Command, or if you're on a PC, hold down Control, and click on this right here, which is the eye, which will actually select the eye, as you can see here. Once that is done, with the eyelid still selected, we're going to click right here to add a layer mask, which will put the eyelid in the eye, which is exactly what we're looking for. Now if we wanted to, we can duplicate this by holding down Alt and Shift and dragging, and then we can go to the top, go to Edit, Transform, and then Vertical. And that will flip it to create our second eyelid. And if we wanted to, we can go in and use our Direct Selection tool and increase the size of the eyelid a little bit. But we're going to leave it at that for now. So there we go. We have most of the eye. We're going to do the actual pupil now. So I'm going to select the left eye, which is the white area. I'm going to make a new shape, which is an ellipse. Make sure it is on new shape. And I'm going to draw out a pupil. That's simple. I'm going to get rid of the stroke on that. And now we have the pupil of the eye. I'm going to position it right in the center. We will be adjusting all of this later on. Now, how do we duplicate this eye to make it the right eye? Well, I'm going to make it very simple. I'm going to go up to the top and I'm going to create a new folder. If you've watched my layers tutorial, you'll know that I love folders and I love organizing my layers. So I'm going to name this left eye, and I'm going to select all the contents of the left eye. I'm going to drag it into a folder. Now with that done, everything's a lot more organized, but we can actually duplicate this, name it right eye, and then we have two eyes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and then 1. So there we go, we now have two eyes of Stewie. Very simple. So what's the next thing we're going to do? Well, we're going to stick with the eyes and we're going to add the eyebrows. Now the eyebrows are very simple. They're just lines. So we're going to go up to the top. We're going to make sure our, first of all, we're going to select our line tool. We're going to make sure our weight is at 2 because that's the size of the stroke we're using. And all we have to do is draw a line. Very simple. And we now have an eyebrow. Now to duplicate it, just like we did before, hold Alt, Shift, and drag. We're going to go to the top, Edit, Transform, and then Horizontal. Boom. We now have two eyebrows. There we go. Next thing we're going to do is we're going to draw his nose. Now again, his nose is very simple as well. We're going to grab our line tool. We can do this, and then boom. Add it like that. And then drag that out like this. And we now have Stewie's nose. And you can, like we did before, go into our direct selection tool and edit the nodes of his nose. So if you want to position it a little bit more like this, let me zoom out to see the original. And we're going to leave it at that for now. So we have his nose, and if we look at our rulers again, we can position it properly somewhere around here. Now, if it's really bothering you, because I know it's bothering me, the color is off, and it's completely ruining the whole persona, if that's even the word. So I'm going to go to my image. I'm going to import my image into Photoshop. And using my eyedropper tool, I'm going to select the color, and I'm going to go in and quickly change the color of Stewie's skin color. Make sure to do it in the eye as well. Bear with me. And I'm going to do it in the right eye. And there we go. So we now have Stewie's. I think it's a little bit darker, actually. I think this reference image is a little bit off. If we look at this reference image as well, but we can always change it later as well. So let's say you wanted to change his eyes around to make them look a little bit more evil, sort of like they are in this image right here. What we can do, we can go over and select the eyelid, this one right here, I think this is the bottom one, and using Show Transform Tools, using your Move tool, you can actually just rotate it and then position it accordingly. And we can do the same thing for this one up here, rotate it a little bit, and then position it accordingly. And then you can grab the pupil, move it over a little bit, and then we can do the same thing for the right eye, like so. Just like that. And grab this pupil, move it over, and there we go. So now we have a little bit more of an evil looking Stewie. And if you wanted to, you can make sure these are positioned properly. But you get the idea. So the next thing we can do, I guess, would be the mouth. Now the mouth is a little bit more difficult to do because it's a little bit more of an awkward shape. So what I'm going to do, just like before, grab our line tool. I'm going to start off by creating a straight line like this. Whoops. I'm going to move it out of my eye folder. And I'm going to make sure it's black. There we go. So now I'm going to zoom in and I'm going to start adding nodes. So I'm going to right click, add anchor point. Add anchor point. I'm going to move this over a little bit. Now what I can do, I can grab these ones here. And I can move them down and that will curve the mouth like you see in the original. I'm going to move these ones over, which will allow me to grab these with me. It's hard to edit on a very small shape. And drag these up to create the curve of his mouth. Now you can adjust it as well, like so, and like that. There we go. So now we have the first part of his mouth. And now to create the bottom part, all we have to do is add another line. We'll add it as a second line and just drag it down. Just like that. And make sure it's black. And edit the nodes accordingly. And there we go. Now it's very basic. It's not proper. It's not exactly what it looks like. But I'm just giving you sort of an idea of how it should be done. Now obviously you can go in there and edit it a little bit better, but that's the basic idea. Now for the hair, it's basically the exact same thing. We're going to grab our line tool. We're going to make a straight line, like so. Make sure it's black. And I am going to zoom in, add some anchor points. And drag these ones here. I'm going to put these ones around here. And then these ones I'm going to put somewhere here. A little bit here. So if we zoom out, we have one of his hairs. Now, it's again, like I said, it's not perfect, but it's a start. And all you have to do now is hold Alt and duplicate, and then edit each hair accordingly. I'm not going to go ahead and edit each and every single hair. But as you can see, some parts are sticking out. So you can grab these nodes and push them up. Then duplicate this over here, and then you rotate them like so. And that's the basic idea behind creating Stewie's head in Photoshop. Now, obviously, there can be a lot more detail added. The mouth is a little bit off. The nose can probably be a little bit better, and the hair, well, you have to finish duplicating it. And as well, the ears, I didn't add the curve over here, but it's the same basic idea. Grab the line tool, edit it, and have fun with that. So in the next tutorial, we will be discussing Stewie's body, which is a lot more difficult. But for something like this, to create in Photoshop, it's fairly simple if you follow the steps. And I hope you've followed along and created a Stewie with me. And like I said, there's a lot more detail that can be added, and I hope you spend the time to add a little bit more detail than I have. So until next tutorial, take care.